What's up everybody, this is Suhail with Angela's Brand, and today we're gonna show you how to flip these slides into something nice for summer 16. What we're gonna be doing today with these kicks, we're actually going to make them into like a Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, 80s kind of retro theme. It's summertime, it's a perfect time to be showing off in some fluorescent, some neon, loud colors, you know, it's been quite a trend. So with that said, guys, I picked up a pair of just basic $25 slides, and we're gonna show you guys how to customize these today and show you how easy it is to do it with Angela's Paint. So let's get started, guys. So these are going to be the paints I'll be using today. Before I start freestyling this, you know, I took a look at some images that kind of gave me inspiration. This is just an example of a reference point. So I took one of these Jordan 7s, the Bordeaux's, and as you guys can see there on the tongue, it has that kind of a retro print as well. So, you know, I'm just keeping this here for reference for myself. And just this Bordeaux tongue actually inspired me to do a hat that was kind of inspired. Same fashion there, you could see the Bordeaux 7 kind of a style print. This was actually done with Angela's Paints as well. So it just shows you the versatility of Angela's Paints. You know, this is not just for slides and shoes, guys. We can use this for a variety of different ways. So let's get started, guys. Gonna prep this guy up using the leather preparer and deglazer. What it does is it takes off the first clear coat that's actually on the slides that protects from stains, from scuffing or whatnot. We're taking that clear coat off first, so that way we can paint this and it'll actually adhere better. Now you guys wanna let the deglazer kind of settle out before you hit any paint on it. Again, this is stripping the clear coat off of the sandal or the slide, so because it's that powerful to strip off a clear coat, it will also weaken the bond with paint. So just make sure that before you start hitting your slides with paint, they're properly dried. Both of these kicks are prepped, so I'm gonna start painting now. What I'm gonna start with actually is these two guys here. I'm going to mix the two together to give me more of a, it's gonna be like an in-between, almost like a fluorescent color. Whenever you're mixing paints, you wanna start off small. You don't wanna dump a bunch of paint in there and then dump a bunch of paint of another bottle, and then decide that color didn't come out great, because then you wasted, or you could have possibly wasted a lot of paint. So look at this, this is like half a bottle of green, but you can see how slow it's pouring out. See that? And now let's take a look at this Neon Tropic Yellow. Let's see how this flows. This is flowing like milk, see that? That might actually alleviate the fact that the green was very thick. And if it doesn't, you just drop a little bit of too thin in there and you can mix it up, so. Today we are using paint brushes. You guys can see I've got a bunch of different paint brushes. Just a recommendation for you guys. After you're done painting, make sure you clean your brushes right away, because otherwise the paint hardens on them and then it's really gunky and it just loses the quality of the bristle. So I'm just gonna pick one of these guys up that I'm comfortable with. This is a flat angular right here. And I like this one because I can actually, when I'm painting, I could just use the tip of it almost like a pen, and that gives you nice like clean lines. So that's what I'm gonna do right now, is let's just, you know, get into it. The good thing about this is there's no right or wrong. You're just going at it and trying to see, you know, what comes about it. So let's start with the little triangle. What you want to do is when you're placing these triangles, guys, you don't want to place them too close to each other, because if you're trying to look for that Bel-Air kind of a theme, you have to orient the colors in a right pattern where it's like balanced, and kind of sprinkle them around the shoe rather than remain focused in one area. It's about the displacement of colors in this, so keep that in mind when you're doing this kind of a theme. When you're painting, guys, you want to try to keep the brush in one direction. It'll help all the streak marks kind of go one way. And then once you're almost done settling with the paint, you kind of want to just give a soft brush off of that excess paint that's on there, just to give a smooth finish. A lot of the purples that I'm laying out, it's the first layer and it looks a little blotchy. Don't worry about that. As you continue to paint layer over layer, you'll start to fill those things in. So again, if you see any kind of pigments or anything of that nature, you want to try to gently brush them off and all in the same direction. That's important to try to keep them in the same direction. At the same time, you want to be very wary of the lines, because you don't want to continue to brush, and then all of a sudden you just barely go over a triangle, and then you'll have to extend the triangle out. So let's jump into another color. We're going to jump into Tahitian pink, guys. So not really changing much, guys, and I'm gonna start maybe like painting a panel or two over here and breaking up the colors a little bit. One thing I wanted to mention about the neons is they are translucent, so it does take several coats for them to really fill in. So don't think you're doing something wrong if you see blotchiness. That's natural for neons. You have to be patient though at the same time. You have to maybe coat it about 4 or 5 times. And when you're coating them, especially in this situation, you want to try to avoid getting it into the triangle spots that you've already painted, because then you'll be able to see the difference. So I'm gonna continue to go through now. We're gonna hit this guy with a gift box blue. I love this color as well. It's a great universal color. This is not a neon, so it should coat a lot nicer. I'm on Paradise Purple now, guys, and I'll be painting this end right there. All right, guys, so I just finished up first layer here of Paradise Purple on the slide here. You guys can see that. It is still a little bit blotchy, so I need to let it dry out a little bit. After it dries out, I'm gonna go over it a couple of more times. And then at the last step, guys, we're going to go ahead and detail this slide up. Let me show you how easy making cheetah print is here on purple. All cheetah print is, guys, is it's a random group and segment of shapes that look very circular or close to circular. There's three things you can do. Number one, you can just make circles. The next thing you got to learn is sometimes they're U's, and what I'll end up doing is taking the top of the U and just filling it in just like that. So it's not a full circle, it's a U with like a little dash on top of it. The last thing for cheetah print too, guys, if you're not making a circle or if you're not making a U, you can also make like a parentheses. And that's how easy making cheetah print is. All right, guys, so I'm gonna show you guys how I achieved this kind of splash-like effect here, pulling out this gift box blue and showing you guys what I do on the purple side first, okay? Sometimes I'll drop a couple of little dots inside of the Nike sign. When you're dropping the dots in or little splash marks in, guys, again, don't think too much about it. There's no exact science. It's just kind of fun to create. little bit of matte black in. You're just dotting little spots and kind of giving the Nike logo a little bit of character. Take a little bit of Paradise Purple, and now I'll just drop them in little sections where I can introduce them into the gift box blue area. There you go. Today we brought you guys out retro Bel Air 80s style, so I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. With that said, my name is Suhail with Angelus Brand. Peace.